economics class. Okay, good afternoon all of you. How are you? Okay, today I will start your Indian economic development 4th chapter, poverty. Okay, have you any idea about what is the meaning of poverty? In class 10, class 9, you have this poverty chapter. Have you any idea what is the poverty? Okay, poverty means the person who can't fulfill their basic requirements or basic needs. Basic needs or basic requirements means what? Basic requirements means food, cloth, shelter, education, and health care. Proper health care system. So okay, now also have the economics class. Okay, who have the geography? Your class also will be going on, but now also the economics. Okay, so poverty means the people who can't fulfill their basic requirements. So the poverty is one of the major challenges or major problem of India. Now see, everyone follow your book, page number 60. In previous chapter, you have studied the economic policies that India has taken in the last 5.5 decades and outcome of these policies with relation to the various developmental indicators. Okay, providing minimum basic needs to people and reduction of poverty have been major of independent India. So after independence, there was one challenge for India to remove the poverty. Okay, and for that reason the government also taken some step to provide the various anti-poverty measures like Pradhan Mantri Yojana, then Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Guarantee Act, this type of anti-poverty program also taken by the government. Now, the pattern of the developmental that successive 5-year plans emphasis laid emphasis on the affluent of poorest of the poor, okay, who also called the Antyodaya, okay, and from the government for them also started some programs for removing the poverty, integrating the poor into mainstream and achieving a minimum standard of living for all. So first the question is, who are poor? So around us, we can see there are the many type of person and who are the poor. How we can understand the persons who are beggar? Obviously, they are poor person. The beggar, the child labor, daily wage labor. Obviously, they are the poor person. So, while addressing the Constituent Assembly in 1947, Jawaharlal Nehru had said, "The achievement independence is but a step, and opening of opportunity to the great dreams and achievements that await us. The ending poverty and ignorance and disease and inequality of opportunity." So, we have to remove or reduce this type of problem. After that, we can reduce the poverty. However, we need to know where we stand today. Poverty is not only a challenge for India, as more than 1/5 of the world's poor live in India. So, world's 1/5 poor who lives in India, it's about 260 million or 26 crore people who are poor in India. And this not only poor, obviously they are not meets their basic needs. Poverty has many faces. Yes, poverty has many faces or many dimensions. Okay, so let's see which these are. And poverty also varies from place to place, from country to country or across time. It has been described in many ways. Most often, poverty is a situation that people want to escape. So, poverty is call to action for the poor and the wealthy alike, a call to change the world so the many more may have enough to eat, adequate shelter, access to education, healthcare system, protection from violence, and voice in what happens in their communities. So, these are the various aspects or various sides or multi-dimensions of the poverty. To know what helps to reduce poverty, what works and what does not, what changes over time, poverty has to be defined, measured and studied and even experienced, as poverty has many dimensions. It has indicators like levels of incomes and consumption level, social indicators and indicators of vulnerability to risk of socio-political access. So, what is the vulnerability? Vulnerability means there are some people or one society or one group of people who are suffered by, or they are chronically poor. Okay. From the few past year they are poor, and upcoming year they remain poor. Okay, they lost their everything, their jobs for any natural disaster, okay, or otherwise the person who is weak, who is ill, who is physical handicapped, there we can say vulnerability. Now the question is, who are the poor? See, you would have noticed that in all localities and neighborhoods, both in rural and urban areas, there are some of us who are poor and some who are rich. Read the story of Anu and Sudha. Their lives are example of the two extreme. Yes, in your book, box number 4.1, page number 61, there is given two story of Anu and Sudha. Okay. Anu's father and mother, they work in as a daily wage labor, and they carry the overload bricks. Okay. And obviously he lived his childhood in the site of the construction, Anu. Okay. And obviously but in case of the Sudha, here his father was a businessman, okay, and her mother was one designer. Okay, and she born in one famous nursing home, and from childhood she gets all the things, all the obviously all the she get all the cares from her mothers. But in case of Anu, we can see that her mother kept her in one cradle, okay, with made by the gunny sack, and after then he go for her job or construction site. And after then when Anu is growing, she collected fruit from the dustbin, and also she had the interest in dance. She liked to dance, but when she at the age 12 year, she also engaged with her parents in the works which carrying the bricks. Okay, so this is the one story of the Anu. And see another cases for Sudha. From the when Sudha is growing, she get education, all the education, okay, she got the good colleges, and she had the interest on painting. So after completing her education, obviously she got one good job, and she known as a one famous painter, okay. But she see here Anu, from the childhood she not got any opportunity of education, okay, any other opportunity for the any better job. So obviously for the twice a meal per day, it is difficult for them. So obviously the Anu, they was the poor, okay. So this is the two case of India, okay. Now push cart vendors, street cobblers, women who string flowers, rick pickers, vendors and beggars are some examples of poor and vulnerable groups in urban area. The poor people possess few assets and reside in kaccha hutments with walls made of baked mud and roof made of grass, thatch, bamboo and wood. The poorest of them, so what the poorest of the poor, they had no any houses, they had no land. The poorest of them do not even have such dwellings. In rural areas, many of them are landless. Even if some of them possess land, it is only dry or wasteland. Many do not get to have even two meals a day. Starvation and hunger are the key feature of the poorest household. The poor lack basic literacy skills and hence have very limited economic opportunities. Poor people also face unstable in employment, and also malnutrition is alarmingly high among the poor. Ill health, disability or serious illness makes them physically weak. They borrow from moneylenders who charges high rate of interest that lead them to chronic indebtedness. So what is the meaning of chronic indebtedness? Chronic indebtedness mean is the poor person for their any work, for their cultivation or for starting one new business, their own business, or buying food or anything, they borrow the money from the money lender at the high interest rate. So what happened? At the end, they can't repay the loan, and again they fall in the debt trap, which is called is chronic debt indebtedness. The poor are highly vulnerable. They are not able to negotiate their legal wages from employers, are exploited. Most poor households have no access to electricity. Their primary cooking fuel is firewood, cow dung cake. A large section of poor do not even have access to safe drinking water. and also they have the lack of citation. There is the evidence of extreme gender inequality in the participation of gainful employment. Okay, so education and indecision making within the family. Poor women receive less care on their way to motherhood. Their children are less likely to survive or be born healthy. Scholars identify the poor on the basis of their occupation and ownership of asset. The state of the rural poor work mainly as landless agricultural laborers. Okay, yes, so maximum poor from the rural areas, they have not their own land. So obviously they cultivated the another's big farmer's land. Okay, so landless laborers who are engaged in variety of non-agricultural job and tenant cultivation with small land holdings. The urban poor is largely the overflow of rural poor who migrated from the rural area to urban area and search alternative employment in and livelihood. Laborers who do a variety of casual jobs and the self-employed who sell a variety of things on roadside and are engaged in various activities because they have no job in their rural area. So that's why they come from rural area to urban area and they sell various type of commodity in the roadside, or they engage in the any type of the they work in any industry or any mill. Now, how are poor people identified? So, who are poor people? Yes, Jyotirmoy, only actually all the syllabus from the Indian economic development, only few portions are deleted or reduced. That means one of the organic farming and another is the part is energy. Okay, from infrastructure it is energy and organic farming. Only this part are reduced, others and all the chapters from Indian economic development you have. Okay, okay. So if India is to solve the problem of poverty, it has to find viable and sustainable strategies to address the causes of poverty and design schemes to help the poor out of their situation. However, for these schemes to be implemented, the government needs to be able to identify who are the poor. For this, there is need to develop a scale to measure poverty. So how we can identify the poor people? So first we have to measure the poverty, after then we can identify who are the actually poor person. In pre-independent India, Dadabhai Nauroji was first discussed the concept of poverty line. He used the menu for a prisoner and used appropriate prevailing prices to arrive at what may be called called jail cost of living. So this is one important thing. Jail
cost of living, which is this one is termed by the Dadabhai Naoroji. Okay, so why he measured the poverty like this? Because see, in the prisoner when they is the jail, okay, so obviously from jail they provided the minimum food for them. So that's why, what are the prices of this food? This is by this we can measure the poverty, because the for one adult person in prison, obviously there isn't the adult person. So for one adult person, how much food needed, minimum food needed, and what is their price? So by this we can determine the poverty. So however, only adults stay in jail, whereas in an actual society there are children too. He therefore appropriately adjusted the cost of living to arrive at the poverty line. For this adjustment, he assumed that 1/3 population consisted of children and half of them consume very little, while other half consume half of the adult diet. Okay, so obviously, which is very very less for living one standard life, because they not get the twice meal per day. Here given the half 1/6%, they having no food meal, then 1/6% half, then only 2/3% get the full meal. So the weighted average of the consumption of three segments gives the average poverty line, which comes out be 3/4 of the adult jail cost of living. Which by this value we can measure, or according to Dadabhai Naoroji, we can measure the poverty line of India. In post-independent India, there have been several attempts to work out mechanism to identify the number of poor in the country. For instance, in 1962, the Planning Commission formed a study group. Okay. So, by this, the government in 1979, another body called Task Force on Projection of Minimum Needs and Effective Consumption Demand was formed. And in 1989, the expert group was constituted the same purpose. So besides these bodies, many individual economists have also attempted to develop such a mechanism. So by this, we can measure the poverty line. So before discussing the poverty line, here I discuss first the type of the poverty. Okay, there is the two types of the poverty. One is the absolute poverty, another is the relative poverty. So let's see. Okay, Jodin Mai. I will tell in the next day how many chapters included in periodic test from Indian economic development. Okay, so next one, types of poverty. There are two types of poverty. One is the relative poverty, another is the absolute poverty.
So what is the relative poverty? Relative poverty means the poverty, okay, when we compare between two countries, one country is the less developed, another country is developed. So which is the less developed country? Obviously this country is relatively poor to another country, to the developed country. So when we can compare from country to country or individual persons to one individual, one is the poor and another is the rich person. So by this comparing we can find out the relative poverty. So in one country obviously there may be some group of the people are the very poor, some group of the people are the richest people. So this poverty we can say the relative poverty. Understood all of you? Clear? Okay. And the what is the absolute poverty? Absolute poverty means when the persons there can't fulfill from the previous, from the many years, they can't fulfill their basic requirements, they are called the absolute poverty. Okay, so absolute poverty is very simple, the persons who can't fulfill their basic requirements, which is called the absolute poverty. And relative poverty means the when we can compare one individual to another individual or one country to another country, which is called the relative poverty. Okay, clear to all? Jyotinmoy, Shobhik, okay. So next day I will define the categories of another categories of the poverty, various type of the poor. So okay, absolute poverty means the person who basically poor person who can't fulfill their basic requirements like food, clothes, shelter, medical healthcare system or the education, they are under the absolute poverty or they are the absolute poverty. Clear? Okay. Okay, so next day I will continue this class. So today I will stop here. So for today, thank you.